Azithromycin is a macrolide antibiotic used to treat a variety of bacterial infections. In this video, let's find found. What is azithromycin? What is azithromycin used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking azithromycin? How does azithromycin work? How to use azithromycin? What is azithromycin? Azithromycin, sold under the brand names Zithromax and Azicite, is an antibiotic medication used for the treatment of a number of bacterial infections. This includes middle ear infections, strep throat, pneumonia, traveler's diarrhea, and certain other intestinal infections. Azithromycin was discovered in 1980 by the Yugoslav pharmaceutical company Pliva and approved for medical use under the brand name Sumamed in 1988. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. The World Health Organization classifies it as critically important for human medicine. It is available as a generic medication and is sold under many trade names worldwide. In 2020, it was the 68th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 10 million prescriptions. What is azithromycin used for? Azithromycin should be used only to treat or prevent infections that are proven or strongly suspected to be caused by susceptible bacteria in order to prevent the development of antimicrobial resistance and maintain the efficacy of azithromycin. Azithromycin is indicated for the treatment of patients with mild to moderate infections caused by susceptible strains of the microorganisms listed in the specific conditions below. Recommended dosages. Duration of therapy and considerations for various patient populations may vary among these infections. Refer to the FDA label and indications section of the entry for detailed information. Contraindication. Azithromycin is contraindicated in patients with a history of severe hypersensitivity, example, anaphylaxis or SJS, to azithromycin or another macrolide antimicrobial. In addition, clinicians should be cautious regarding the concomitant use of azithromycin and other medications that prolong the QTC interval, example, antipsychotics. Azithromycin is contraindicated for patients taking the first-generation antipsychotic pimazide. Macrolide antimicrobials inhibit CYP3A4. The same cytochrome that metabolizes pimazide, concomitant use of azithromycin with pimazide can cause dangerous plasma concentrations of pimazide, leading to QTC prolongation and, potentially, lethal arrhythmias. Additionally, azithromycin is an inhibitor of P-glycoprotein/ABCB1, a cell membrane glycoprotransporter. Drugs that are substrates of P-glycoprotein, particularly those that are also substrates of CYP3A4, may represent a relative contraindication to azithromycin. Examples include colchicine and small molecule calcitonin gene-related peptide, CGRP, antagonists. Azithromycin effectively preserves FEV and ameliorates bronchiolitis obliterans, BO, with no effect on overall survival in lung transplant patients. However, a study comparing azithromycin with placebo for the prevention of BO in hematopoietic stem cell transplant, HSCT, demonstrated decreased BO-free and overall survival with azithromycin. Side effects. Most common adverse effects are diarrhea, 5%, nausea, 3%, abdominal pain, 3%, and vomiting. Fewer than 1% of people stop taking the drug due to side effects. Nervousness, skin reactions, and anaphylaxis have been reported. Clostridium difficile infection has been reported with use of azithromycin. Azithromycin does not affect the efficacy of birth control, unlike some other antibiotics, such as rifampin. Hearing loss has been reported. Occasionally, people have developed cholestatic hepatitis or delirium. Accidental intravenous overdose in an infant caused severe heart block, resulting in residual encephalopathy. Pharmacodynamic. Macrolides stop bacterial growth by inhibiting protein synthesis and translation, treating bacterial infections. Azithromycin has additional immunomodulatory effects and has been used in chronic respiratory inflammatory diseases for this purpose. Mechanism of action. In order to replicate, bacteria require a specific process of protein synthesis, enabled by ribosomal proteins. Azithromycin binds to the 23S rRNA of the bacterial 50S ribosomal subunit. It stops bacterial protein synthesis by inhibiting the transpeptidation/translocation step of protein synthesis and by inhibiting the assembly of the 50S ribosomal subunit. This results in the control of various bacterial infections. The strong affinity of macrolides, including azithromycin, for bacterial ribosomes is consistent with broad-spectrum antibacterial activities. Azithromycin is highly stable at a low pH, giving it a longer serum half-life and increasing its concentrations in tissues compared to erythromycin. Half-life. Terminal elimination half-life, 68 hours. Dose. The dose of this medicine will be different for different patients. Community-acquired pneumonia. Indicated for treatment of community-acquired pneumonia due to chlamydophila pneumoniae, Haemophilus influenza, Mycoplasma pneumoniae, or Streptococcus pneumoniae in patients appropriate for therapy. 500 mg POX1 dose on day 1, followed by 250 mg POQ day on days 2 to 5. Pharyngitis or tonsillitis. Indicated for treatment of pharyngitis/tonsillitis caused by Streptococcus pyogenes as an alternative in individuals who cannot use first-line therapy. 500 mg POX1 dose on day 1, followed by 250 mg POQ day on days 2 to 5. Uncomplicated skin/skin structure. Indicated for treatment of uncomplicated skin and skin infections due to Staphylococcus aureus, Streptococcus pyogenes, or Streptococcus agalactiae. 500 mg POX1 dose on day 1, followed by 250 mg POQ day on days 2 to 5. Acute bacterial exacerbations of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Indicated for treatment of acute bacterial exacerbations of chronic bronchitis due to Haemophilus influenza, Moraxella catarrhalis, or Streptococcus pneumoniae. 500 mg POQ day for 3 days or alternatively, 500 mg POX1 dose on day 1, followed by 250 mg POQ day on days 2 to 5. Acute bacterial sinusitis. Indicated for treatment of acute bacterial sinusitis due to Haemophilus influenza, Moraxella catarrhalis, or Streptococcus pneumoniae. 500 mg POQ day x 3 days. Genital ulcer disease, chancroid. Indicated for treatment of genital ulcer disease in men due to Haemophilus ducreyi, chancroid. Efficacy in treatment of chancroid in women has not been established. 1000 mg PX1 dose. Non-gonococcal or gonococcal urethritis and cervicitis. Indicated for treatment of urethritis and cervicitis due to Chlamydia trachomatis or Neisseria gonorrhoeae. 1000 mg POX1 dose. Pelvic inflammatory disease. Indicated for treatment of pelvic inflammatory disease due to Chlamydia trachomatis, Neisseria gonorrhoeae, or Mycoplasma hominis in patients who require initial IV therapy. If anaerobic microorganisms are suspected of contributing to the infection, administer an antimicrobial agent with anaerobic activity in combination with azithromycin. Safety advice. Azithromycin is categorized as pregnancy class B. The data for risk of congenital malformations associated with use of azithromycin during pregnancy ranges from no risk to a small increased risk. That's all the information about azithromycin we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.